God, and you know the name of God, the power of the Almighty God, the anointing that breaks the yoke. If you are going to preach, preach. And there was, you know, a particular place in one of the locations in Nigeria, and they were sent a new region overseer there, and that new overseer, when he came there, the brother is not from that area. The people came to him and, you know, they said, "We are here." And he didn't understand. And then another team came and said, "We are here." That means they said they were in the town. And they rushed into that place. And then when later I was asking some of his people, he said, "Some people came to me and they were saying, 'We are here.'" And I don't understand. And those people laughed. They said, "You don't know this area. This area, this is what they mean. They mean that the people that have the power of darkness, that they were there." And then because he accepted what they said, because he meditated on what they said, he then became afraid. And when he came to the pulpit, he'll be trembling, he'll be shaking, he'll be shivering. He'll not be able to bring the words out. And I knew him. And God told me to appoint him as a region overseer at that time. And I knew the power of God was in his life. And then I just decided, you know, I'd spent some time in Lagos having this combined service, that combined service. I decided I was going to visit the states, not to preach, not for programs, and stage people. I hope you understand. You know, some of these people in the state, anytime I come, they sing, "I only come for preaching. I only come for crusade." And state people listen. If I want to come, I just come. I don't have to preach. And then I go to his location, and he called me and said, he said, "Pastor, since I got here, I'm not like I used to be. In fact, I wanted to come and tell you to send me back to where I was coming from. I'm happy to just be local government pastor as I was. Instead of staying, I cannot talk. I cannot preach." I said, "What's your?" I said, "All right, let's go to church." There was no meeting that day. And then I just went around. He followed me. You know, like my boy, I was talking to him, and then we were talking and discussing. I walked around the church building, and then I came to the pulpit, and I stood at his pulpit. I said, "Now you are released, preach. Now you can preach. Now you can preach. Praise the Lord." I didn't preach, I didn't even pray. I just stood there and touched that pulpit, and I said, "Now you can preach." And then I came back to Lagos. And, you know, he got to me later. I said, "Pastor, the first time I preached, when we had a meeting, all those people began to fall down. They were just falling down like this and falling down like this. And the ushers were carrying them out." And he said, "Since that time, Pastor, now I preach." "You will preach." I said, "You will preach. Because there is power in the name of God, and that power will go back with you in Jesus' name." Here it says in verse 5, "And I shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flies by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. But it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee." There shall no evil befall thee. Anywhere you go, there shall no evil befall thee. "And then neither shall any plague come near thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet, because he has set his love upon me. Therefore, I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name." Do you know the name today? "You will call upon the Lord. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him. I will honor him with long life." with long life. With long, if you know the name, if you know the name, if you trust in the name, with long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. If you know that name, stand up and mention that name. That name gives you the protection you need. That name brings power into your life. That name communicates and makes authority to flow into your life. That name gives you healing. That name gives you deliverance. That name communicates and brings the power of the Almighty into your life. Because he knows my name. Because he knows my name. He calls upon me. He calls upon me. You know the name. Mention that name. Mention that name. Mention that name. Abraham knew the name. The name of God Almighty. What will he not do? What can he not do? God Almighty. Think about that name. Meditate on that name. And look at the depth and the power, the height, the breadth, the length of the name. Infinite name. God Almighty. Is anything to your heart for me? Is there anything God cannot do? This Almighty God. This Almighty God, all the mountains he can roll away, he can melt everything away, all the problems he can dissolve them, and every confusion in your life he can blow everything aside, because he is God Almighty. Is Jehovah. He is Jehovah. And because he's Jehovah, Jehovah who saves, Jehovah who heals, Jehovah who transforms, Jehovah who delivers, and because of his nature, is good, is righteous, is holy, is merciful, is faithful, is truthful. What promise has he given you that he will not fulfill? What promise has he given you that he will not fulfill? All his promises are yes and amen in Christ. You know that name of God, the name of God, the name of God. And you can come in that name with confidence, with authority, with power, with trust, with faith. You can come in that name and all your problems are over. What power? Darkness can stand before the name. What evil thing can stand before the name? What magical power can stand before the name? What power of darkness can stand before the name? The name of God. The name of God. Because he knows my name, he will call upon me. Because he knows my name, I will deliver him. Because he knows my name, no evil shall befall him. Because he knows my name, all his needs are supplied. When you know the name and know it through and through, all the fears will be gone. All the anxiety will go. All the worries will go. You know the name. You know the name. You know the name. The name of God. You'll be able to face your Goliath. You'll be able to face Pharaoh. You'll be able to face anyone, everyone. Because you are not representing yourself anymore, you are representing the Almighty God. And they defy the name of the Almighty God and they say, we'll see what God will do. The battle is not yours, the battle belongs to the Lord. And then you'll be able to stand and you'll declare like David. You come to me with spear and sword. You come to me with all the gadgets of natural human warfare. I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, whom you are defied. And then they'll come down, whether you have a sling or not, you have a stone or not, you have any gadget or not, you have any other thing or not, whether you know people or you don't know people, the name of the Lord alone in your mouth, that's enough, that's enough, that's enough. And that name will work wonders in your life. Know the name, trust in the name, believe in the name, stand in that name. Have confidence in that name. the name of God, the name of God. Abundant provision because of the name. Abundant protection because of the name. Supernatural power because of the name. The goodness of the Lord because of the name. The name, the name, the name of Jesus and the name of God. Impossibilities made possible because of the name. All difficulties removed because of the name. The challenges in your life addressed because of the name. Yokes broken because of the name. Curses removed and destroyed because of the name. Blessings flowing into your life because of the name. Joy, fullness of joy. Fruitfulness. Success. The fulfillment of the promise of God. Happening to your life because of the name. The name of God. The name of God. The name. The name. No more anxiety because you have the name. No more worry because you have the name. No more fear of man because of the name. No more fearing to go and sleep. Bad dream. Oppression in the night. Attacks in the day, in the night. No. You know the name. And because you know the name, you're free. Miracles come because of that name. Failure is turned to success because of that name. The suffering of mysterious things gone, cancelled because of the name. The power of the Almighty God coming upon your life because of the name. Satan defeated. Demons defeated. Evil spirit defeated because of the name. All those magicians subdued because of the name. Your prayers answered because of the name. And you live a fulfilled life, a joyful life, a happy life, a satisfactory life because of the name of God. The name of God of the Lord is a mighty tower, a strong tower, and the righteous runneth into it. And you say, the name. Have confidence in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. You fear nothing. You fear no one. No dark power. No evil power. Even natural power. Magical power. Powers of darkness. You fear nothing. Because of that name. Make sure you represent that name. Believe in that name. Be faithful to that name. Be confident in that name. The name, the name, the name. The name of God. And believe the Lord for something definite today. Be because of the revelation does he not have on the name of God? Something definite, spiritual, moral, physical, natural, something you want him to do in your heart, in your life, in your Christian life, something definite. Because of the name, you know the name, you know the name, you know the name, and because you know the name, you're full of expectation, great, great expectation. Release your faith in that name, and then heaven will release unto you all the blessings contained in that name. In Jesus' name we pray. Now if you have trust, confidence, expectation in that name, another good amen. You know, I'm told, I learned in the Bible that the people of God, when they came together and then they prayed, the place was shaking, and then the devil trembled. And even without their prayer, without commanding this and commanding that, then all the prison doors were open and all their chains were loose. Is there an amen that will make the devil to tremble? Is there an amen that will make even hell to shake? Is there a kind of amen that will make all the powers of darkness flee away, and then they will keep their distance away from you? If there is that kind of amen, where is that amen? Praise the Lord! We serve notice to all the people anywhere they are that have any power of darkness. We serve them notice. We have the name. We have the name. We have the name. It is that name that sacked Pharaoh and all his cohorts in the Red Sea. It is that name that defeated Goliath and all the Philistines. It is that name that kept Daniel in the lion's den. It is that name that made Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to walk all through the fire, and they were not hurt. I will serve announcement to everybody, and we want to say, we have that name in this church. We have that name in this church. We have that name.